We are live on Facebook.
Okay, I'm bringing up music, background music. And we are live. I'll wait patiently for things to come my way.
Someone else's fault. Feels like I've gone crazy, like the women in my family usually do. We can't seem to keep our heads on.
I can't share it on
long enough to make it through. Oh, but I'm still sensitive and stubborn.
God.
Yes.
So cry more than
yes.
A person should.
Mm-hmm.
But it's this feeling inside that's changed. Like I've gone bad, but the world is good. Oh, but it must be someone else's fault. Must be someone else's heart tainted.
I remember every town and every hotel room, every song I ever sang on a guitar out of tune. I remember everything.
Doing good, Tim? You about ready?
Things I can't forget. The way you turned and smiled on me on the night that we first met. And I remember every night your ocean eyes are blue. How I miss you in the morning light, like roses miss the dew. I've been down this road before, alone as I can be.
Am I live, Scott? Are you telling me? Okay, welcome everybody. We are inside the Avalon Theater live tonight. This is Saturday, June 13th. And we have a wonderful show for you to listen to tonight. Just a quick announcement. Next weekend, I believe we'll have Dan Navarro on. I think it'll be Saturday night as well. Lowen and Navarro fame. But tonight, it's been a beautiful day here on the Eastern Shore. I don't know where all of you are watching from. I hope it has been as beautiful where you are as where it has been here today, because it's just lovely out. And people are moving about and doing different things now a little bit. But if you're at home or you had some friends over, or just sitting by yourself, sitting with your quarantine partner, you're cleaning up after dinner tonight, please enjoy this wonderful, wonderful act we have for you tonight, Mary Fall. Mary's been playing here for a couple years now. She's familiar with the area. And I am so interested to hear tonight this wonderful, world-class quality voice influenced by so many different types of music and how it's going to come through digitally tonight. But if you set your volume right and you just turn it up perfectly, I think it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful show. She's also for viewing wise. If you look at any of her videos, even if you watch the video that she did for the Scott and Tim show that we recorded last week, she is one of those singers, and I know I've said it about one other person, I cannot remember. I've been here 15 or 20 years. She emotes every note, and it's just wonderful to listen to and watch. I'm sure she has a very special set built for you all tonight. Please welcome Mary Fall.
Start off with the most requested October Project song, and one that's kind of apropos for this time. Here we go.
My name is Ari Neville, and I want to be free. It is your sorrow that has made a slave of me. Forgive me, but you who are all I know, forgive me for the day is breaking, now it's time to go away. I'm so afraid to leave, but more afraid to stay. Forgive me for leaving the sadness in your eyes. Forgive me. Let the wind and ocean water wash across your hands. wash away a thousand footprints, wash us all away, bloody sand. The sky has fallen now. Oh, you're tired from the violence of the storm. I love you, but you who are all I know, forgive me. Let the wind and ocean water wash across your hands, wash away a thousand. Wash us all away. Oh, let the wind and ocean water wash across your hands. Wash away a thousand memories. Wash us all away like sand. My name is Abigail.
Okay, so that, as I said earlier, is probably the most requested October Project song that I get. And when I asked everybody on Facebook, that just came pouring in. So the other song that is sort of, I like to start off with October Project songs just because that's sort of where I began my career. And it's probably why so many of you are tuning in to this day. And one of our hits was the following song, and a weird thing happened when I was just after October Project. My husband and I were at one of these fancy cocktail parties that we don't frequent, believe me. Both of us tend to be a little bit shy and retiring, so we usually end up talking to the catering bill. But so we're not good networkers, you know, but anyway, there we were, and we ended up talking to one of the wealthiest humans on the face of the earth. And this guy asked me what I did. You know, we were making cocktail party chit chat, and he said, what do you do? And I said, I'm a singer-songwriter. And he said, oh, would I know you? And I was sort of, well, probably not. And then I said, well, I was with this band called October Project, and this guy was one of those October Project fanatics that you never know where they're going to show up. And he said, October Project. And then he said, you saved my life. And apparently this is the song that got him through his, what I would imagine was a very expensive divorce. So this is called Return to Me.
You rise like a wave in the ocean, and you fall gently back to the sea. Now I want to know how to hold you. Return to everything I feel for you. I know what it means to heal. And I know what it means to be free. Now I want to know how to love you.
All right, Mayor. Hey, this is Scott. How you doing?
Glad
to have you in tonight. Thanks so much for doing what you do. We're having some minor volume issues.
Okay.
And I disconnected your cell phone, so we're only going to go with one camera.
Okay.
And as far as if you have any other devices that are all on your internet right at this time, it's probably best to log out of those because we're getting some phase issues with the connection.
Okay. Well, hold on.
Maybe that might help a little bit. And thanks
hold
so much.
On. So should I just turn my phone off completely?
That'd be great.
Okay, I'll do that. Hold on. Just gonna turn it off. All right, that's off. And I think I know. Hold on. I'll just log out of this. How's that?
Okay, let's rock and roll. Thanks so much.
Is that better now?
Yes.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. I'm going to switch guitars for a minute here. And so this next song, I was going to sing on my last live show, and then I chickened out. I learned this in high school, and this was one of those songs that I had ordered. You remember when the Columbia House would let you order like 12 albums for $1, and this was one of the first albums that I ever bought for myself, and I think I must have been around, I don't know, 13 or so, and I was in those vulnerable teenage years when you listen to something over and over and over again, and it just goes right in, you know, and stays there. And so I decided, I've been thinking about this song a lot this week, and I was gonna chicken out because I hadn't played it in so long, and I had to. It was almost like when I was relearning it was like muscle memory in my hands, because I used to, this is one of the songs I used to play up in the bathroom. I used to lock myself into the bathroom with the good acoustics, and I would record myself singing. I had a little reel-to-reel tape recorder. So this just feels right for what everybody's been going through these past couple of weeks. So. This is an old Neil Young song. Hold that line by the side of the road where the lorries rolling by. Blue
from the weight of the load and the buildings scrape the sky. Cold wind ripping through the alley door, and the morning paper flies. Dead man lying by the side of the road with the daylight in his eyes. Don't let it bring you down. It's only castles burning. Find someone who's turning. You will come around. Blind man running through the light of the night with an answer in his hand. Come on down to the river of sight and you can really understand. Red lights flashing through the window in the rain. Can you hear the sirens roar? White cane lying in a gutter in the lane when you're walking home alone. Don't let it bring you down. It's only castles burning. Find someone who's turning. You will come around.
Almost remembered it completely, but anyway, I love that song. The other most requested song that I get is one that I wrote for my husband. Poor Rich has been out tonight chasing our guinea hens, and we have a we have 13 guinea hens, and they lay delicious eggs, but they run away at night, and you can often find us on a Saturday evening chasing them through the woods and trying to wrangle them back home. So, and they eat ticks too, which is why we got them. They eat lots of ticks all day. So, yeah, this is a song called Gravity that I wrote for my husband a while back. This was for a very pivotal birthday, and he's one of those people that's impossible to buy anything for. So I mean, I had to do it, and he wasn't making it easy at the time because he kept giving me suggestions that were not helpful. Like, I guess over breakfast one morning, I was still in the midst of working on this song, and he looked over at me while he was eating his Cheerios, and he said, you know, I've been thinking a lot about that song, and you know what song I really like? Bridge Over Troubled Water. I want something like that. So I got to work, and I was trying to think of sort of what was the essence of Rich, and what made him worthy of a song. And I was thinking about him as a young athlete. He had been a gymnast when he was young, a very good one. And so I like the idea of him defying the gravity of space and then defying the gravity of the ocean as well. My husband's a deep sea oceanographer, and he goes down in that little submarine called Alvin all the way to the very, very bottom of the ocean. So I thought it would be a good metaphor. And then I was also just thinking about what made him a good human being, really good. And I had seen him sort of do things for people behind the scenes on lots of occasions, you know, things that they would never know he did for them. And then one day, I saw him get somebody's job back. I mean, it was, you know, impossible. I mean, it was done, you know, the deal was done, and he just went in, he pulled a string, he did this, and suddenly the guy had his job back, and I said to him, my God, Rich, you could turn a river around. You really could. And so I suddenly thought, well, that's it. That's what he does. He moves mountains and turns rivers around. So, so this is my song. I know you've always been a good, good man on the straight and narrow. A knight, a shining archer, order of the arrow. But tonight, with all your weapons down, you're feeling scorn and scar. I'll bind your wounds and comfort you, 'cause I know who you are. I've seen you move mountains, turn rivers around, defy the force of gravity with both feet on the ground. Under the weight of the world, I've seen the kindness that you show. So tonight I'll be your harbor. Tonight I'll be your home. And faded photos is a younger man that I might know. I see the toll that all this time has taken on your weary bones. And I know you loved a woman once. Oh, how I wish it had been me. But I had to learn the harder way. Freedom don't come free. I had to move mountains, turn rivers around, defy the force of gravity with both feet on the ground. Under the weight of the world, in those dark nights of my soul, a heart without a harbor, a heart without a home. Now some come to pass the lonely time, some are here to stay. Some come to teach us lessons, and some just make us pay. But we're born to love another, it's no good to be alone. 'Cause we all need a harbor, we all need. We'll move mountains, turn rivers around, defy the force of gravity with both feet on the ground. And in the weight of the years, we'll disappear from our souls. And I'll always be your harbor. Oh, in my arms you'll find your harbor, in my arms you'll be home.
So, I'm going to do a song now that is my favorite song in the whole world. I do it at every single show. It's for those of you who really don't know a lot about me, if you're just seeing me or hearing me kind of in a live situation for the first time, I've told this story about this song many, many times, but I love medieval music. I love medieval history, I found this song in in Spain. I was on tour with October Project, and it was one of those rare days off. You know, they were hustling us through all these major European cities, and so I found this in a sort of dusty old record store, and I love the music of medieval Spain, especially all that beautiful Sephardic music, the Ladino music of Spain, and so I was hunting mostly for that kind of stuff, but I came across this song when I got home, and I fell madly in love with it. You can fall in love with a piece of music instantaneously, and I've stayed in love with it, and it's partially because, as some of you who have seen me live know, I love to sing in foreign languages. There's something just, I love all those delicious words, you know, and so this is a song that's in Mozarabic, which is a really beautiful, archaic patois of Spanish and Arabic. It's a beautiful language. I had to get it translated by a professor of medieval Spanish at Indiana University. And she said that the literal translation was, "Oh, my beloved, I've been longing for you, you know, pacing the floor, waiting for you, you liar." I guess he was going to get there earlier. He was late. And so then she says, when you get to my house and you finally kiss my little mouth, you won't be leaving too soon. So, God, I love this song. So this is called, and I got to record this during a very magical time of making The Other Side of Time, which I made on Sony Classical. And I'd always dreamed of recording this, and we had these amazing musicians on this song. So this is called Ben Aindi Habibi.
Yeah.
other song that I was getting a lot of requests for was this is a song that was the first, well, this was our first hit, I guess, with October Project, and it was very exciting. It was very exciting to get signed to a label for the first time, and exciting, you know, we had worked so hard, and the first time that you hear your song on the radio, it's just the most thrilling experience, you know. And I have to say that through all the ups and downs that you know, my career has had, I was very lucky that I was signed to a label, that we were signed to a label in days when they were still taking chances on new artists like us, and, you know, really pushing us out in there. And it's why I still have a career to this day, actually. Yeah, I'm really grateful for that. So this is another most requested song. Sometimes it's a little dark, so I don't often do it. These are interesting times, so it's kind of appropriate. So, ladies and gentlemen, I give you Bury My Lovely.
Bury my lovely heart.
boy. So the other song that was requested is really the first song I ever wrote where I felt I finally cracked the code of how to write a good song, because it took me a while. It was probably learning to write songs was next to performing by myself for the first time, because I was terrified, you know. But learning how to write songs was absolutely the most frightening thing I have ever done in my life. Because, you know, the October Project songs were beautiful. So that was a high bar. And you just, you know, when you're starting something out like that, I think this is probably true for any kind of art you begin. You really have to have a lot of guts to be bad at it at first, you know. But you learn a lot that way. And I started writing with good songwriters. And I learned little tricks here and there. And one of the things I learned to do was to keep a notebook. And a lot of times, from the bad songs, you'll get one good line and you'll end up being able to use it. Sort of like I harvest bad songs for like the one good thing in them sometimes. But this is the first time I wrote this song on the bus going home to Hoboken on a very rainy night. And I was feeling a little sorry for myself. And I was very lonely. And so I was remembering a friend of mine from a time that my sister and I spent in Portugal, and sort of some of the travels that we had. And I was missing someone who really understood me, you know, just got me from the get-go. So this is for my old pal, Paolo. And happy birthday, Gary, because I know you wanted me to play this for you. So here we go.
Paolo, where have you gone? Have the spirits found you? You are wanted. See him, the man in the tall hat, brown with an eye grim, always standing there, watching by the door. I think you always knew what he was waiting for, and power, understanding my was true. With the lenses of contact, you could see through. Oh, you could tell me what I should do. Power, I've seen evil, it wore me down. And I would have made games if you'd been around. See through, oh, you could tell me what. if you've been around. Oh, in the darkness, where are you
another foreign language song. And again, I chickened out on my last live stream, but I had been working last year on this album of French songs, and you know, the music of my soul is music from sort of early 20th century France. I love Debussy and Ravel and Satie and Poulenc. He's a little later, but you get the idea. And but I think my favorite is Ravel, of course. But this is in French, but it's actually not a French song per se. It's a melody by Brahms. But I love this song because it's very, very cinematic me. And so I know most of you probably don't speak French, but it paints a scene. If this were a movie, it would open up to a scene of a couple in the middle of the night, and they've obviously had a terrible falling out, and you know, they're each on opposite sides of the bed, and it's those moments when you're obviously in the doghouse with somebody, and it's that middle of the night sort of reaching over to say, I'm sorry, and please forgive me. And kind of having that feeling that that other person is gone. You know, whatever you did, it just pushed them too far. So anyway, this is called The Waltz of Regret, La Valse des Regrets.
L'orgue de l'ennui, au clair de la lune, j'ai mis la brise en fer de son archet, chanter la valse des regrets. Mon bel amour, au bois dormant, quitté vos rêves éternellement, vous éveillant du doucement. Venez vers moi qui vous attend, venez vers moi, il est grand temps. Comez vers moi, ton cœur qui bat, devant de voix de deux, prière faite. L'autre s'allonger, des forêts glissant sans bruit. Et du passé, vestiges usés, nos souvenirs s'en vont danser. Comme l'arc-en-ciel après la pluie, comme le soleil après la nuit, serai je sèche et je serai mon peine. L'orgue de la nuit, au clair de la lune, j'aimais toujours dans mon couloir qui n'attend plus que votre.
Anyway, isn't that a pretty song, though? Gosh, I love that one. So, let's see. I'm going to do a song I learned years and years ago, and we all know it. And this is another one of those songs that I used to sing up in the bathroom of the house that I was growing up in. And you know, I talked about that little reel-to-reel tape recorder that I found in my mother's basement. And, you know, I tried it out to see if it still worked, because as I said, I used to record myself singing and lots of Joni Mitchell and Carly Simon. I loved Carly Simon and Leonard Cohen. And the problem with some of the songs, I would play that for you because it's like funny to hear the little, you know, 11-year-old me. But in the middle of some of the songs, you'll hear this. So, get out of there! So we had a big family. And that was the good bathroom. So anyway, I love this song because it's a song of innocence and experience, and you hear it one way when you're young and so differently when you're older. But it's another one of those songs that goes straight in. So you guys all know this.
Goes and flows an angel hair, and ice cream castles in the air, and feather canyons everywhere. I've looked in clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain in snow on everyone. So many things I would have done, but clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's clouds' illusions I'm on. I really don't know clouds at all. Moons and Junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing wing feet, when every fairy tale real. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go, and if you can't, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now, from give and take, and still somehow it's love's illusions I'm on. I really don't know at all. Tears and fears and feeling proud to say I love you right out loud. Dreams and schemes and circus clouds, I've looked at life that way, but now old friends are acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed. Well, something's lost, but something's gained in living every day. I've looked at life from both sides now, round good and lose, and still somehow it's life's illusions I really don't know.
So I want to say a couple of words about the Avalon Theater. So I'm supposed to be playing there on August the 7th, hopefully. One never knows in this day and age, but hopefully I will be there. It's in a beautiful part of the country called Easton, Maryland, and it's in the Tidewater area of Maryland. I love that. I love, you know, I love going crabbing and all of that stuff. My parents used to take us there when we were little, so they had dear friends who lived there. So, and you'll notice if you're watching this on the Avalon site that there is a suggested donation, and you know, a lot of venues now around the country are really struggling. I don't think bureaucrats who make these rules understand how businesses run, and you know, it's going to be very challenging to run with 30% capacity or whatever rules they're going to instill. But they really, really need your help. So it would be really great if you would make a donation. And and try to do that for a lot of these live venues that are doing streams. I don't know how they're going to make it. So it really will help. Okay. And you know, I miss you guys. This is very strange for me. I mean, this is where I work all the time. It's a little cramped here tonight, but it's strange because I miss seeing your faces, and I'm really gonna miss shaking your hands after shows, because I actually really I love that physical contact, you know. I really do. I like hugging you guys and taking pictures with you and all of that stuff. Many of you have become my friends over the years. So God help us. I hope we all get to be in the same room together again. I really do. So I don't know. Are we, how are we doing on time? So are we about towards the end of the show here?
Yeah, we're getting close. You want to do a couple more? We'll it'd be wonderful.
Yeah, I'll do one here. This is a, you know, now I'll keep this. I was gonna do another song, and then I realized I had promised someone that I would do this next song. So this is a song that I wrote for a Civil War film. This is when I was on Sony Classical, and you know, they were wonderful to me. They didn't quite know what to do with me. They were exploring a new label called Sony Odyssey, but they wanted me to write for movies, and you know, they couldn't guarantee that my songs would get in, but you know, I at least I had a conduit in, and I saw that they were doing this Civil War film, and the thing is, my dad and I shared a love of Civil War history, and he used to sing. My dad used to sing those beautiful Stephen Foster songs to us when we were children. You know, those songs like Jeannie with the Light Brown Hair and Beautiful Dreamer. So I thought, well, I'll try to write something like that. And I went back and I read the Jeff Shara novel. So I got to work on this. I was co-writing this with Byron Isaacs and Glenn Patcha from Olabel, if you know Olabel. And I was working on the lyric, and right in the middle of writing the song, I found out that Bob Dylan had gotten the gig, and I thought, and had been given an enormous sum of money to write it. And I thought, well, there goes my chance. I don't have a holy chance in hell of getting in. And then, so I thought, well, what the heck, let's just finish the song and turn it in. But, you know, we didn't put a whole lot of effort into the demo. Normally I would have gussied that demo up and made it, you know, amazing. But no, it was just kind of a raw demo. And I gave it to my A&R fellow at Sony Classical and kind of forgot about it. And then when the director of the film, Ron Maxwell, was visiting 550 Madison, the big Sony building on Madison Avenue, you know, he was there, I guess, to talk about the record that would have the soundtrack on it for the film. And they said, listen, you should hear this song because it really would go with the film. He said, no, everything's done. No, don't want to hear it. They said, no, come on, just listen. And so they brought him into this very sterile conference room in the building and sat him down. And, you know, they had these giant Sony speakers. They played the song for him. And they told me later that as he was listening, he went up to the speaker and he put one hand on the speaker and another one on his heart. And when the song was over, he said, she really, really gets this. She gets the story. And so my song at the beginning of the film and they put Bob's at the end. So there you have it. But, you know, when I wrote this, it was mostly, I wanted to write a real soldier song. And an interesting thing happened. I had really hoped, you know, I had visions of Oscar in my head. But the movie didn't do very well at the box office, to put it mildly. It was the same year that Cold Mountain came out. So everyone and their brother wrote a song for Cold Mountain. So I didn't have a chance in hell, which is awful because the next year they didn't have enough songs to submit for the Oscars. And the song that won was called It's Hard to Be a Pimp. So it was just bad timing on my part. But, you know, years later, I started getting and still get to this day, I get letters from military men and women. I don't know how they come across the song, but I always had a theory that maybe they played the movie on overseas bases or something. But in any case, I've gotten the most, you know, beautiful, heartfelt letters from people that somehow this song really, really resonates with soldiers. And there was one letter in particular that just really moved me very deeply. And it was a fellow that had several tours of duty. And he said that at night when he couldn't sleep, that this song was really soothing for him. And I guess I'd rather have that than an Oscar getting dusty on a shelf. So this is called Going Home. They say there's a place where dreams have all gone. They never said where. But I think I know it's miles through the night, just over the dawn, on the road that will take me home. I know in my bones I've been here before. The ground feels the same, though the land's been I've a long way to go. The stars tell me so. On this road that will take me home. Love waits for me round the bend. Leads me endlessly on.
we've lost and all that we've won, when this road finally takes me home. When I pass by, don't lead me astray. Don't try to stop me, don't stand in my way. I'm bound for the hills where cool waters flow, on this road that will take me home. Love waits for me round the bend, leads me endlessly on. Surely sorrows shall find their end. All our troubles will be gone, and we'll know what we've lost, all that we've won, when this road finally takes me home. I'm going home. I'm going home.
Going to do one more for you now, and I want to tell you about a wonderful Blu-ray. I'm so happy and so proud of it. So you guys know that most of you who follow me know that I released an album years ago. I actually never like formally released it, but it was my version of Dark Side of the Moon, and It was a daunting task, and I had two amazing producers, Mark Doyle and David Werner, and together the three of us climbed this musical Mount Everest. And unfortunately, we got a deal, which was, you know, really, actually, to be honest, very surprising to me. And we got a deal on V2 Records, which was a wonderful label. And just as this record was about to come out, the label folded. And which was heartbreaking. And but they, at the time, they sent me you know, boxes and boxes full of the advanced copies. And so, you know, I've been selling those at shows for years. But this album was mixed and engineered by Bob Clearmountain, who is probably one of, if not the best surround sound, immersive sound engineers in the world. And he just did an amazing job on this. But we thought that surround sound mix had been lost, because the mastering engineer, I guess there was a fire in the studio, and it was gone. So Mark Doyle, my producer, found this thing in his, amongst his audio files. And so I wasn't sure if it would, you know, be worth releasing or whatever. So I sent this to a friend of mine, a dear friend who was very ill at the time. And I sent it to him. He was an audiophile, and he, hello, Rich.
Hello.
Yeah, how are you doing? And I said, would you take a listen to this and see if it's worth releasing? And he called me back, having listened to it, and he said, Mary, this thing is the Hope Diamond of surround sound mixes. And I said, oh, you're just saying that because you like me. And he said, no, I'm telling you, you have to release this. And so Mark and I got to work, and it was remastered, and I had new artwork done for it. And I love the new artwork. I was never really happy with the artwork on the V2 record. And I have a wonderful graphic designer and named Julie, and she's got her design studio is Haggis Vitae, and I described to her my feelings, the sort of philosophical underpinnings of this record. The poor girl, I chewed her ear off for an hour, and I said, you know, I want you to illustrate sort of almost like the digital djinn that are coming down and sort of taking over our world. And so she managed to capture that right here. There it is. There's me looking up at the moon, and you can see that binary code falling down like rain. I mean, she just got it. She's a wonderful designer, Haggis Vitae Studios. Anyway, this is now for sale on my website, maryfall.com. And it's also, so you have to have a Blu-ray player, and you have to have a 5.1 surround setup to hear this. Or if you don't have a Blu-ray player, you can go to immersiveaudioalbum.com and download it. And I certainly don't know how to do that, but it's, you can download it there. And again, immersiveaudioalbum.com. And I really, really am proud of this. And if you are an audiophile, it's been getting wonderful reviews on various sites online that are for audiophiles. And so just, you know, just get it. Okay. If only for the Bob Clear Mountain mix, you should get it. So I am going to close the show and play something from that album for you. And another song that is very apropos for our time. And just a sec here. Yes, I said, yes, Rich is giving me little notes. Yes, I said you have to have 5.1, a 5.1 setup to listen to the Blu-ray. So I will close with this. So, you know, it's so funny. I'm more nervous playing in front of a little camera because I can't see you all, but I could play in front of a stadium and not be nervous, you know? But this is just a little sweaty. Okay. So, but thank you all if you tuned in. I'm going to be doing another one of these next week for another fabulous place called The Ark in Ann Arbor, Michigan. So you can tune in next week at 8 p.m. And I'm going to do brain damage for you. Here we go. Hold on. Okay. The lunatic is on the grass. The lunatic is on the grass. Remembering games and daisy chains and laughs. Got to keep the lunatic on the path. The lunatics are in. Every day the paper boy brings more.
awesome.
Thank you, everybody.
That was great. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. And then we can't wait to see you live on the Soul System Room stage. It'll be nice when we kind of get back to some type of normalcy. So again, thanks very much. Everyone, thanks for tuning in. I'm live.
Don't forget to leave a tip for the theater, for the Avalon.
And we appreciate that so much. Again, we'll see you soon. Thanks so much, everyone. Have a great night.
Good night, everybody. Good night.